हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ अ स्कैंडल इन बोहिमिया वन फॉर क्लास एट स्टूडेंट्स. इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी स्टडीड दैट डॉक्टर वॉटसन वॉज मिसिंग हिज फ्रेंड कम कलीग शर्लॉक होम्स, सो ही वॉन्टेड टू विजिट हिम एंड ही वॉज वेरी श्योर दैट होम्स वुड बी हैप्पी सीइंग डॉक्टर वॉटसन. When Dr. Watson visited Holmes, Holmes demonstrated his deductive genius by deducing some specific pieces of information about Dr. Watson, which delighted him so much. We also studied that Holmes showed shared with Dr. Watson about his recent case and showed him the letter he had received from one of his client who announced that he would visit Sherlock Holmes wearing a mask to hide his true identity. So the two men were discussing the peculiarities of the letter, deducting that it was written by a native German speaker using paper made in Bohemia. Already I had explained you in my previous video. Now up to here students, we stopped our previous video. A man entered who could hardly have been less than 6 feet 6 inches in height. His dress was rich, means he was a well-to-do person. Well-to-do means rich or wealthy person. Today we will begin from this paragraph. He wore a black wizard mask. Wizard mask means a kind of mask used for hiding face, extending down past the cheekbones. Student, these are very important informations and you have to remember the appearance of the visitor, his height, his appearance, what he was wearing. So you have to mark it properly. Extending down past the cheekbones, he looked from one to the other of us as if uncertain which to address. He looked from one to the other of us means Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson were present at the spot, and he was actually was confused that whom he had came to visit or came to meet with. Means he was actually trying to identify Sherlock Holmes. "Pray take a seat," said Holmes. "Pray" means please, "take your seat," said Sherlock Holmes. "This is my friend and colleague Dr. Watson, whom have I the honor to address?" Means here Holmes is asking that the man who was wearing the mask was asking his identity, by what name he should be honored or addressed by Sherlock Holmes. Students, I hope you have understood up to here. Now, just listen. I will read the summary. So, the man who entered the apartment wearing a mask and was dressed very richly or luxuriously introduced or addressed himself as Count von Krumm, a Bohemian nobleman. Understood? So Holmes insisted that Watson should be allowed to stay for the consultation. Actually, the client was hesitating to disclose his case in front of Dr. Watson, but Holmes insisted or requested his client, the man wearing the mask, to disclose all his informations in front of Dr. Watson for any type of help or consultation. The person comes to see, now he is disclosing or discussing about his case. So the man has come to see Sherlock Holmes due to his reputation. Actually, here he wanted to save the reputation of one of the royal families, and he needs help with a case that could seriously bring down the reputation of the royal family of Europe. When Holmes says he knows he is speaking with Wilhelm von Ormstein, king of Bohemia. So you can see here, if your majesty would consent to state your case. Here we can understand that Sherlock Holmes quickly unmasks him. So means he had already understood that he is talking none other than the king of Bohemia himself. And he requested him to disclose his identity. See this paragraph. With a gesture of desperation, the man tore the mask from his face. So as soon as Sherlock Holmes unmasked the man tore off his mask and acknowledged his real or true identity. So this was who was the person behind the mask? The man was none other than the king himself. Now, come to this paragraph. Your majesty had not spoken before I was aware that I was addressing Wilhelm Gottfried Sigismund von Ormstein, hereditary king of Bohemia. So, who is the speaker here? Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes stated that before revealing the identity itself, the Sherlock Holmes understood that he is none other than the king of Bohemia himself. Now, see this paragraph. I am not accustomed to doing such business. Here, who is the speaker? The king of Bohemia is the speaker. I am not accustomed. Accustomed means habituated. To doing such business means masking or masking himself or covering his real identity. But the matter was so delicate. The matter was so weak, so delicate that I could not confide it to an agent. Here confide means he could not believe or he could not give this case to hand over to any agent. The facts are briefly these. Some 5 years ago, I made the acquaintance of the well-known adventuress Erin Adler. So now the story of the king of Bohemia begins. The king explains his case from here. Students, please listen carefully. That he was engaged some 5 years ago. He had a short relationship with a well-known adventuress and opera singer, Erin Adler. He sent her a number of letters and a photograph of the two of them. Two of them is Erin Adler and the king himself. And now the lady, Erin Adler, was using or threatening or blackmailing to use those items to ruin the king's marriage. So now at present the king was going to the king is engaged to marry the princess of Scandinavia. Understood? But the threatenings from Erin Adler had made him very upset. Now from this paragraph you can see that the king's men have tried to buy and steal the photo and letters but have had no luck. Means they failed in all their attempts. 5 attempts had been made. Twice burglars in my pay ransacked her house. Means 5 times they attempted to get those photographs and letters from her house. The burglars also turned upside down or searched thoroughly her house. Once they diverted her luggage, changed the direction of her luggage when she was traveling. Twice she has been waylaid, but there was no result. Waylaid means stopped by somebody midway while traveling, but there were no results, no sign of it, absolutely none. Holmes laughed. So this made Holmes laugh that the king had some irresponsible acts or attempts. Listening all the theories, listening all the attempts made by the king, Sherlock Holmes agreed to take his case, telling Watson to return at 3 o'clock the following day. He asked Dr. Watson, his friend cum colleague, to be with him in to help him in solving the case. You can see here, Watson, he said once the king left, if you will be good enough to call tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock, I should like to chat this little matter over with you. So students, this story, please read it thoroughly, properly, and the story is very easy. Try to connect the incidents properly, make the notes somewhere, write down the notes and read the meanings, consult the dictionary and complete this part 1 of a scandal in Bohemia. I shall continue A Scandal in Bohemia 2 in my next video. Thank you.